One of the things you notice really quickly when you're studying the parables of Jesus is that often they're the way that Jesus decides to try and teach us about the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven, this reality of how God intended things to be and the destination to which Jesus is calling us to get to, right? Like, except the kingdom of heaven has kind of this duality to it that sometimes we don't fully talk about. It has this duality in that the kingdom of heaven is both now and not yet. Salvation both has come and yet has not been fully realized. Eternal life is now, but not quite yet. With the arrival of Jesus, there's hope for both now and for eternity at the same time. And so there's this duality to the way it works. Salvation is here and it's coming. And so Jesus tells this parable, right? And this parable illustrates things beautifully. It's found in Matthew 13. It says this, Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, "Sir, didn't you sow good seed? I mean, in your field, where did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he replied. The servants asked him, "Do you want us to go pull them up?" "No," he answered, "because while you're pulling up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat with them. Let them both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, 'First collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn.'" You see, there's a weed named darnel or darnel. And it's a weed that mimics wheat. Especially at its younger stages, you can hardly tell the difference. Is it a weed or is it a plant that's going to produce something edible? And as it grows, its roots will actually reach down into the earth and intertwine with the wheat and the plants that it's nearby. So it's incredibly infectious around it. And it can really grab a hold of various things. If you yank it out, you risk yanking out wheat that is growing and has a chance at life. I think that negativity and fear seem to sprout around us at the same time that any good thing does. And the negativity and fear, we're kind of like those servants. Like, we tend to look and say, "God, what are you doing? Have you seen? I thought you made this world to be good. What's going on?" And he says, "Hang on. Wait. Because the kingdom of heaven is now, but it's not quite yet." In the same way, we're saved, and yet there's this process in us where we have faith growing, and at the same time, there are other things that sometimes pop up, and we'd like to shed them, but we'll never quite be totally rid of them until that not yet, until that harvest comes along. And I think that leads us really, really to our last point, and that's that it's really easy to judge and to look out at the world, maybe look at other people, maybe even look at people in a church or look people in our neighborhood or look at people in our workplace and kind of categorize them and say, "No, this is that kind of a person. This is that kind of a person. They don't really have a chance there." And miss over the fact that God is working and the kingdom of heaven has a seed. It is sprouted. It is growing and it has a chance at growth and life. But if we attack those weeds that we see around us and we just start going on a weed pulling terror, we're gonna yank out a lot of good with it. So Jesus has this warning in us to not judge, but to be patient, to not look for the weeds, but look for the wheat. Look for the good around us instead of just being consumed with the negative. Celebrate the positive. Look for the kingdom. Look for God's work. It might be tangled up in other things. And it's complicated. There's wheat and there's darnel. There's wheat and there's weeds, and they're all kind of mixed up. But salvation is there. It is growing. It is both now and not yet. So have hope. Look for the good. We can still celebrate now and look forward to celebrating more in the not yet. Let me pray with you. God, thank you so much that you are our God now and not yet, that you do have patience, God, for those seeds that are growing and those lives that have a chance to get to know you but haven't quite gotten out of the weeds. God, may we have patience. May we be full of grace because you showed so much grace to us. May we not judge ourselves too highly nor others too lowly. And may we embrace the now and the not yet. We look forward to your return someday. Amen.